Almost 70 years ago, a German soldier was killed in World War II. An American not only took his life, but also took his personal belongings, including his wedding picture, which was strapped to his body. It wasn't uncommon to do this, but this is uncommon. That American soldier, now 92 years old, recently returned the pictures to that German family. Here's NBC Bay Area's Cheryl Hurd.
We're going to go over the ridge. We're going to go behind them. We're going to come back over the ridge. We're going to head them from the rear.
Howard Hensley remembers 1944 like it was yesterday. The Army veteran was on the front lines of World War II and in the heat of battle when he killed a German soldier during a firefight in southern France.
So the sergeant that I'd chosen to fire the first shot fired. Then, of course, they hit the dirt and there's firing going back and forth all the time.
Hensley, an intelligence officer and assistant platoon leader, says he knew the German soldiers would not give up without a fight. He says he gave them several chances to surrender, but in the end, a single German soldier was the only holdout.
How did you feel when you had to shoot George Reich?
I thought it was something I absolutely had to do in order to save our own man. I've got to admit that I didn't feel sorry for him. I felt sorry that he didn't give up when I gave him a chance. When you take prisoners, you get all the information off all of them. And I hate to admit it, but they don't end up with their watches or rings or anything else.
In this case, George Reich was stripped of all of his personal belongings, including pictures of his wife and family.
These pictures were in a protected place in the bag that he carried on his back.
The pictures included Reich's wedding photo. Hensley later put them in his personal scrapbook. They stayed there for 68 years until one day, a young French writer interested in documenting World War II found Hensley on the internet.
He came here to Menlo Park to interview me for his book.
From France.
From France.
Wow.
The wow factor didn't stop there. The French writer felt he might be able to return the pictures to the German soldier's family. He contacted the mayor of the small German town where the soldier lived. The mayor recognized the dead soldier and put Hensley in touch with another George Reich, the soldier's grandson.
He wondered, like you did, why didn't his grandfather stop firing?
He expressed his feelings through this email.
Thank you so much for the photographs of my grandfather. He realized that we were both soldiers and that either one of us could kill the other one.
Ultimately, Reich's grandson forgave Hensley. And now, 70 years later, the pictures thought to be lost forever will go back where they belong, to the family of a one-time enemy, a single soldier who refused to surrender. In Menlo Park, Cheryl Hurd, NBC Bay Area News.
Une découverte étonnante. 62 ans après la fin de la Seconde Guerre mondiale, 13 cadavres de soldats allemands ont été retrouvés puis exhumés. Ça se passe dans un bois de Villeneuve-Loubet. Explication Vincent Yagui.
Les squelettes reposent ici, juste à un mètre de profondeur. Une fouille méticuleuse pour faire ressortir de terre l'histoire de la guerre 39-45.
Bon, là, c'est un crâne qu'on a trouvé ce matin encore à l'intérieur du casque allemand, vous voyez. Donc le crâne, il est abîmé malheureusement, mais bon, on reconnaît encore. Il y a même encore une petite mèche de cheveux du soldat, vous voyez.
L'histoire est ressortie de terre grâce à ce jeune étudiant. C'est lui qui a localisé la fosse après une longue enquête auprès des habitants du village.
Les habitants étaient tous plus ou moins au courant, mais par contre personne ne savait exactement où c'était, ni si ça n'avait pas été déjà exhumé il y a 50 ans, quoi, voilà.
Tout un village au courant, mais personne n'ose dévoiler l'affaire jusqu'à aujourd'hui.
C'est pas un secret de Polichinelle, disons qu'à la libération, il y a eu plusieurs morts allemands.
Alors les habitants, ils les ont mis sur des charrettes, ils ont creusé un trou, ils les ont enterrés ici, bon, tous mélangés.
Je me souviens bien sûr de la tranchée ouverte, de la terre qui avait été remuée.
Aujourd'hui, il ne reste plus que les casques, des munitions, des gourdes, mais surtout les plaques des soldats avec leur matricule.
À travers ça, effectivement, on va pouvoir mettre une identité précise dessus.
Les plaques seront envoyées à Berlin, puis restituées aux familles. Les corps exhumés restent en France. Ils seront inhumés le 23 juin prochain au cimetière militaire allemand de Berneuil, dans les Charentes-Maritimes.